democracy is at stake, folks. Our democracy is under attack. And we got to fight for it. I taught at the University of Pennsylvania for 4 years, and I used to teach political theory.
I taught at the University of Pennsylvania for 4 years, and I used to teach political theory. That is untrue. That is President Joe Biden just lying about his time at the University of Pennsylvania. There's a little kernel of truth, or an emotional truth, as comedian Hasan Minhaj might say, another news story. But no, Biden was an honorary professor at UPenn for just over 2 years, from February 2017 until he launched his 2020 presidential campaign in April 2019. Biden made numerous appearances at the school during that time frame, including to hawk his book, but never taught a single class there. That's actually not the first time he's lied about academia. In 87, he boasted about finishing in the top half of his class at Syracuse University Law, despite having finished 76 in a class of 85 students. Definitely in the lower half. He's also claimed to have been the outstanding student in the political science department during his undergraduate career at the University of Delaware, despite there being no record of his having received such an award. So I don't know what this is. This is just sort of old man generalizing, but like, yo, it wasn't that long ago, Mr. President. I don't know if you should be telling this lie.
Yeah, tyt.com/dropout. So look, guys, it's no joke, as Biden would say. So there's only two possibilities here. One is it's a weird and outrageous lie. Because okay, you forgot that it was 2 years and not 4 years. I'm not gonna call that a lie. I'm gonna call that a mistake, and I'm gonna move on with my life, right? I mean, if you give me Biden and Trump, I say Biden in a landslide. So I'm not predisposed against the guy just generically. And by the way, even if it was Trump, if he said 4 years instead of 2 years, that'd be the smallest lie he ever told in his life, right? But he had details about teaching class, and he never taught class. Nah, this guys, look. I want him to drop out. We're doing the petition to drop out. You got the link down below. I'm asking you guys to sign it. We get it to, you know, I know it sounds like a huge number and we're nowhere near it right now, but you get this thing to go viral and get like a million signatures on it. We're gonna have a national conversation about this, because we desperately need a national conversation about this. Because the only two possible explanations is, one, he's losing it. He doesn't remember anything and he's just making stuff up. Because he's just not mentally there, or no, he's mentally fine and he's just been a giant liar his whole life. And so I know politicians lie on a regular basis, but Biden, man, he has a history of this. He dropped out of the 1988 race because of charges of plagiarism, a couple of things that Franny told you. He said that he got arrested with protesting apartheid in South Africa. He never got arrested in South Africa. That is an outrageous lie. And then just a couple of days ago, he said that he was at ground zero the day after 9/11. These are bad lies, man. There's something wrong with Joe Biden, and us not being honest about it doesn't help anyone. That's my opinion. Mark, what do you think?
Well, I would still say on the medal stand of the lying Olympics, Trump gold medalist, and I don't know, maybe Biden is a bronze medalist. I mean, I just don't see these as even comparable. I certainly agree with everything Cenk just said when it comes to those issues with Biden. He's in a sense reconstituting his past. I don't know if that's a deliberate thing, a wishful thing, an age thing, but if it's some blend of those things, it's still not a good thing. And again, they're big, dangerous lies, and then they're smaller, less dangerous lies. This isn't a dangerous lie. I mean, you could say it's dangerous in terms of its reflection on him. I would agree with that. But the notion somehow, you know, the election was stolen and, you know, animating an entire population to go take over the Capitol, that's a really dangerous lie. And there are a lot of other lies that came out of Trump that way. So in the, again, the lying sweepstakes, I really see Biden as an also-ran. This is an endorsement. This is not an endorsement of all of this, but it is to say that, God, I'm losing the serious lies in the in all the other less serious lies, because it seems to be an age in American politics where there's lying going on all over the place. We expect more from Biden, especially given the fact that he's sort of made it his North Star, being truthful and, you know, returning the moral compass of America. And so it's a really, really, really bad look.
I mean, we will storm UPenn over this, Mark. I don't know. Like, I'm there. Look, it kind of reminds me of a story that we just covered, which was, you know, a lot of mainstream centrist news outlets casting doubt on Vice President Kamala Harris and also casting doubt on Joe Biden for his age. It feels like, do they know something we don't know? Are there Mitch McConnell, Dianne Feinstein moments behind the scenes that we haven't seen? Because look, I do think he is old. I think he's probably misremembering or just doesn't, you know, kind of again painting with this broad old man memory brush. But I think Cenk, I disagree. I think he does cobble two sentences together, and I do think he's got a beating heart and he's breathing. Like, and I do think he can beat Donald Trump yet once again. And I think even more so because he actually has a record to run on, whereas before, arguably, he didn't. And I think he would have lost outright had Donald Trump not bumbled the pandemic response so horribly, and if there wasn't a pandemic. So yeah, that's where I'm at with this. But maybe there is something, especially since corporate media is echoing it, that we don't know or that we're not seeing.
Yeah, I think we are seeing it. I think we just don't want to see it. So that's my take on it. But look, let me break it down to two different categories. Mark is right, Francesca's right. In it, like, I don't want anybody to confuse what I'm saying. Donald Trump is the world record holder in lying. It's not even close. No one will ever be close to him. I mean, he once said that he invented the word fake. I mean, he's like an Austin Powers character, right? Right. So it's nothing could ever rival him on that. He's number one. He's tired of winning the lying contest, okay? He's got every goal in the book. But it's not just Donald Trump. The Republican Party is a lost cause, man. I mean, then you got George Santos, but it's not just like the ones that have been caught and brazen, flagrant, etc. I mean, the whole party's built on lies that the 2020 election was stolen, that COVID's not really real, and the vaccines don't work, and Bill Gates is tracking you with the vaccine. Just lunacy after lunacy, lie after lie. I mean, even before the Trump era, Louis Gohmert said that Obama was going to reconstitute the Ottoman Empire. Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, right? He said if Obamacare passed, literally every Republican, I write about this in my book, Justice is Coming. Rick Santorum, Louis Gohmert, I can't remember all the names, but like dozens of names, all saying ridiculous things. Gohmert again jumps to mind because he said 20% of all women in America would die if Obamacare was instituted. Have we lost 33 million women and I didn't notice? No, this party is filled to the rim with gigantic liars who lie as a regular course of events, right? As course of business. So now, but when you move over to the Democrats, you also have standard politician lies, right? Oh, I care about you. Give me the money, donors, right? That's most of politics. But among the Democrats, Biden is known to be probably the biggest fabricator. Like, honestly, of my life. I mean, he got 88. I'm old enough to have witnessed and remember the 88 election, and he gets driven out for lying. He gets in trouble again for lying later, and again, and now again. And so it's a pretty clear pattern. And and my point isn't Biden versus Trump. That's a no-brainer, okay? My point is, why are we going with a hobbled, wounded antelope into what is supposed to be the most important election of our lifetimes? And Fran, just to real quick, we can debate it later, maybe in a TYT special, but he's 15 points lower than he was when he squeaked out a victory in 2020. 15 points lower. And being an incumbent is not an advantage, it is a disadvantage. Everything that goes wrong gets hung on you. So it's a massive disadvantage. It's an advantage when you're a senator or you're a congressman because you have much more name recognition. But when you're running for president and you got the two major candidates, name recognition is not at all a factor, and incumbency turns from an advantage to a huge disadvantage. And then finally, look, people always say, hey, who else can do it? Someone else that doesn't have this track record? Someone else that isn't, you know, this old, and we're all conjecturing if they're lying or if they're losing their mind? The fact that that's a question means I'm sorry, brother, but you shouldn't be the candidate. And I think it's actually incredibly selfish to be the candidate. I mean, I would like to think that if I was him and I was in his situation, that I would figure out, guys, who are our best guys? And remember, one other super important lie. Biden said that he'd only be a one-term president. And now he's saying, yeah, just kidding. No, my power and my ego is more important than the Democratic Party, more important than our voters, and more important than the country. And I think that's the most devastating one of all.
I'm not suggesting that that's wrong, Cenk, but I will say this. I mean, you're allowed to, I always feel like, especially when you talk about politicians flip-flopping, you always hear about that. You are allowed to change your positions and you are allowed to change your disposition toward running again if there are decent reasons to do so. My problem is I don't see the decent reasons to do so, but just deciding that you are going to run again for, I don't view that as a lie as much as I do. Maybe it's a technical point that isn't, you know, it's lacking a real distinction, this difference, but I don't see it as a lie. I just see it as a change of position, but maybe I'm really just being kind to the guy.
Yeah, we could debate whether that's a lie or not. And I hear what you're saying, Mark, I do. But the reason why it's the worst one is not because it's the most egregious lie, but because it's the most impactful. And it's having a massive impact. And guys, is there anyone else? Of course, if you think there's no one else in the Democratic Party that could beat Donald Trump, you're saying the Democratic Party is absolutely pathetic. That we can't find one politician who could beat the most odious man in American political history. I mean, I wouldn't, as much as I have insulted the Democratic Party over the last 20 years, even I wouldn't insult them that much.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.